Hey folks, this is BestInSlot with a quick little update video for Jurassic World Evolution 2. Should only take a couple of minutes. We're going to take a look today at update 1.72, the newest patch for the game, just came out for consoles and PC. And like most other patches, it's, you know, bug fixes and little localization changes and stuff like that. Nothing too exciting but necessary. But there are two pretty cool little changes in here that I want to highlight and that we're going to check out in game. The first one is some changes to decorations. Update 6 added two new supply pile decorations to the game, one with a wheelie bin, a trash can, whatever you want to call it. But the problem was these two new decorations replaced the old decorations, the supply piles 01 and 02. So now we should have supply pile 01, 02, 03, 04, giving us more variety, double the number of decorations, and access to that bin decoration and the old ones. We'll see that in just a second. But the big change is this bad boy down here. Removed the gap between the play area and background forests on maps. There's going to be a small gap on existing saves, and new saves will have no gap at all. Your big new square maps we got in the last update, they were fantastic, but they were, you know, sans trees all the way around, and the edges of the map were completely empty with trees. So as soon as you added trees around the outside, you got this really weird, very clearly man-made square shape going on. Now it should look a lot more naturalistic. That's going to affect Isla Nublar 1993 and 2015, Canada, Sierra Nevada, my beloved Biosyn, and Malta. We're going to go check that out in-game as well and see how it looks now they've updated it. So we're here on Isla Nublar 1993, and you can kind of see the difference already, but if we hop into map mode, as you can see, the map lines now cross into the trees outside of the map as well. In the past, basically, there was a line here of just no trees whatsoever, so when you added your own trees at the end of the map, like so, it would then cross into nothingness on the other side. It looks super weird. There are still gaps. They've actually done it really well. As you can see, the ridges of the mountains here, as they come down, they are without trees. So if you put trees in those areas, as you can see, you're still going to end up with your weird little line, but that's probably the best of both worlds, because if you had it the other way around, you know, just trees everywhere on the outside, then every time you had a blank space, it would look weird. So now you can kind of play with the environment a little bit, you can work with what they've given you, and it should let you make your parks a whole lot more naturalistic looking, gives you a lot more variety, and, you know, just looks a little bit better. Yeah, really, really good change. Really happened very quickly because the square maps are really good, but that was kind of a major niggle. Just to finish things off, we're going to very quickly look at the decorations. If you go down to your fourth tab here, you'll see we have these supply containers, so supply piles are one, some crates and barrels, which I'm sure is a store in America. And number two, which is a crate. Just lovely crates, which I don't think is a store in America, but it should be. So these are the ones that we had prior to update 6. Then update 6 comes along, you know, brish and brash. These are words. Well, one of them is. And it added supply pile 3 and it added supply pile 4. But unfortunately, they'd replaced these ones. And now, as you can see, we've got access to all 4 of them. So if you haven't seen these before, these are pretty good. We've got ones here with the barrels with a pallet. I love a pallet. And we've got some wheelie bins here. Lovely wheelie bins and some trash bags. Never doing that again. In front of the bins. And then this one over here is basically the same as that one there. But it's got these sort of little sort of trays, plastic trays falling off at the front. Just a little bit more variety, mixes it up a little bit more. So now, you know, it'd be really cool if we could get some of these as individual items that we can place in our park. I would love that. A little bit more flexibility with the decorations, but this is definitely a good step in the right direction. A little bit more variety for absolutely everyone. And who doesn't love a wheelie bin? Who amongst you does not love a wheelie bin? Exactly. That's it from me. Not the biggest thing in the world. We will be back later on tonight, however, with another video. Just thought the square map update in particular was worth bringing to people's attention, because I think that's going to be pretty blimmin' popular. Let me know what you think of the patch in the comment section down below. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video somehow, and I will see you lovely folks very soon. Have a fantastic weekend. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.